Hi students, in this video we are going to learn Let's March part 3. First of all we will read the paragraphs and after that we will explain it. First paragraph, part number 3, Let's March. I call upon all governments, intergovernmental agencies, business, faith leader, workers, teachers and NGOs and each one of us to put an end to all forms of violence against children, slavery, trafficking, child marriages, child labor, sexual abuse and illiteracy. These things have no place in any civilized society. So, in this paragraph, Kailash Satyarthi requests to all governments and intergovernmental agencies as well the businesses, leaders, workers, teachers and NGOs. And by that request, he just want to say that we have to stop the all kinds of violences which are we found for the children. We have to stop each and every type of violences. After that, Kailash Satyarthi talks about the problems which in this era so many children are facing, in that slavery, trafficking, child marriage, child labor, sexual abuse and illiteracy. These are the main violences, okay, main problems in the society. And we know that as a civilized society, we should not give any place to such kind of things, okay. We have to stop, we have to do some things to stop such type of violence, okay. Such type of request Kailash Satyarthi do to all governments and intergovernmental agencies, okay. So the simple thing we have to know that as a part of civilized society, we have to stop the violence. And we know that there are so many forms of violence against the children, in that slavery, trafficking, child marriage, child labor, etc. Okay, we have to stop these things and we have to enlighten the society. Next para. Friends, we can do this. Governments must take child-friendly policies and invest in education and young people. Businesses must be more responsible, accountable and open to innovative partnerships. Intergovernmental agencies must work together to accelerate actions. Global civil society must rise above the business as usual and fragmented agendas, faith leaders and institutions and all of us must stand with our children. So, in this paragraph, simple thing we have to know that Kailash Satyarthi gives the importance to the education policies, okay. Government must make the policies which are much friendly to the children, okay. Child-friendly policies government has to make for the children. And one more thing, government must invest their best in the education field and in the young people, okay. When any government gives importance to education, definitely that generation becomes clever, talented, and we know that that is very responsible thing as well, very useful thing for the nation, okay. After that, when we are providing a child-friendly education policies at that time, we must give the importance to the children's future also, okay. After that, whatever the government is taking the actions about the education at that time, the policies of education must be innovative, okay. That must give the importance to the innovativeness of children, okay. Advanced ideas must be used in the education field, because when we use a new ideas in education field, it means we are growing, otherwise we are losing our future, okay. And at that time we have to give importance to the various agendas, okay. As a part of global civil society, we must rise the businesses, as usual and fragmented agendas. Okay, it means whatever the problems we are facing, we have to stop that problems, we have to do something for that problems, we have to find the solutions. And one more thing, Kailash Satyarthi wants to talk faith leaders and institutions. Okay, these faith leaders and institutions must stand for the children. Okay, and if these leaders and institutions ready to stand for the children, then definitely we cannot find any violence against the children. Okay, each and every children can live their own life as beautiful as others. Next, we must be bold, we must be ambitious, and we must have the will. We must keep our promises. Okay, over 50 years ago, on the first day of my school, I met a cobbler boy my age sitting outside the gate of my school. I asked my teacher why is he working outside, why he is not with us in the school. My teacher had no answer. One day I gathered the courage to ask the boy's father. He said, "Sir, I have never thought about it. We are born to work." So in this paragraph, Kailash Satyarthi just used to say a short event, okay, experience of his life which was happened, or the event which was happened before 50 years when Kailash Satyarthi was just a schoolboy. And in that story, he used to say that when he was a school child, at that time he met a cobbler boy who was sitting outside the school gate, okay, and working there as a cobbler. Okay, and at that time Kailash Satyarthi used to ask his teacher, "Why that boy is not sitting with us in our classroom, or why that child is not getting education like us?" But that teacher doesn't have the answer at that time. Okay, and lastly, Kailash Satyarthi gathered the courage and asked the father of that boy, "Why your child is not going to school?" And at that time, the reply given by that cobbler boy's father, that was making angry to Kailash Satyarthi. And in that reply, the cobbler boy's father said, "Sir, I have never thought about it, and we are born to work." Okay, it means we have to know that most important thing in the society, there are so many communities, so many peoples are there who are not thinking about to give the education to their child. Okay, and they thought our birth is only for working, for only to provide the services to the society. And if such type of thing, such type of thought we find in the society, then definitely we cannot enlighten, we cannot develop. So we have to stop such type of thinking, and we have to do something for the children who are not going to school, okay. His answer made me angry. It still makes me angry. As a child, I had a vision of tomorrow, a vision of that cobbler boy sitting with me in my classroom. Now that tomorrow has become today, I am today and you are today. Today, it is time for every child to have a right to life, right to freedom, right to health, right to education, right to safety, right to dignity, right to equality, and right to peace. Today, beyond the darkness, I see the smiling faces of our children in the blinking star. Today, in every wave of every ocean, I see my children are playing and dancing today in every plant, in every tree and mountain. I see our children growing freely with dignity. So in this paragraph, Kailash Satyarthi just want to say that when he was child, at that time he had a vision of tomorrow. Okay, means in future he had a vision to do something for the children who are not going to school or outside, who are outside the school. Okay, and he thought that the children who are like that cobbler boy, who are not sitting with others in a school, in a classroom, he decided to do something for them, and that tomorrow's vision becomes today. Okay, And that today means now we have to give importance to the all kinds of children who are facing such type of problems. Okay. After that, Kailash Satyarthi speaks about the rights. Okay. Which rights each and every child has to get in their life. The first right is that right to life, how to live our life, then right to freedom. Each and every children has to get the right to live their freedom life, then right to health. Each and every child has get the good health, right to education. When we decide such type of visions at that time, we have to know that we must not find any children who are not going to school. Each and every children we have to find in a classroom. Okay. This is right to education. We have to get the right to educate ourselves, right to safety, right to dignity. Okay. Dignity. This is the most important thing. Dignity, it means self-respect. Okay. Each and every person has a right of dignity, and same thing Kailash Satyarthi want to say that right to equality. We should not find inequality in the society. Each and every person is equal. Each and every child is equal. And right to peace. Our life must be peaceful. And after that, we have to know that beyond the darkness, when we see, we have to find our children in the blinking stars. Okay. Now we can find our children's who are playing and dancing. We can find our children in plants, in mountain, and everywhere. They are growing freely with dignity. And only happen this because of the response of the society. Okay. When we give response to the good work, then we can solve so many problems. And now Kailash Satyarthi find his children. His children is all children. Okay. Now they are working in a best field. Okay. And after that, Kailash says, friends, I want you to see and feel today inside you. My dear sisters and brothers, as I said, many interesting things are happening today. May I please request you to put your hands close to your heart. Close your eyes and feel the child inside you. I am sure you can now listen to that child. Listen, please. So, in this paragraph, Kailash Satyarthi requests to the audience, okay, who are gathered there to listen the speech of Kailash Satyarthi. Kailash Satyarthi requests there to put their hand close to their heart and close the eyes and just feel the child who is inside them. Okay. And after that, Kailash Satyarthi used to say that when we feel that, definitely we can listen that innocence sound of that little child which is inside us. Okay. And after that, he says, today I see thousands of Mahatma Gandhi's, Nelson Mandela's, and Martin Luther King's calling on us. Okay. So these are the great persons, examples given by Kailash Satyarthi. And that are Mahatma Gandhi, Nelson Mandela, and Martin Luther King. We know that the contribution of this person in the society, we cannot forget anyway. Mahatma Gandhi spent his whole life only for the development of the society. Nelson Mandela spent his whole life only for the development of their community, black community. Martin Luther King, who also work for the society. Okay. Means as a human being, these persons only give the importance to the human beings society. Okay. They are not giving importance to the caste, religion. Okay. They focus only to enlighten the society, to give the importance to the development of the society, to educate the society. And afterward, they become educated person. Okay. And lastly, Kailash Satyarthi says that let us democratize knowledge. Democratize, it means make democratic. It means knowledge and education is free for everyone. Each and every person has to get the education in the proper manner. Let us universalize justice. Each and every person has get the proper justice. And together, let us globalize the compassion. Okay, we have to show the compassion for the all globe, all world. We have to show the compassion, kindness, our love for the all kinds of children. Okay, and lastly, Kailash Satyarthi says, I call upon you in this room and all across the world. I call for a march from exploitation to education. I call for a march from poverty to shared prosperity, a march from slavery to liberty, and a march from violence to peace. Let us march from ignorance to awakening. Let us march from darkness to light. Let us march for mortality to divinity. Let's march. Okay. This was the last paragraph. And in this paragraph, Kailash Satyarthi requests to all the world, all the people, we have to march from exploitation to education. Okay. It means exploitation means to take undue advantage of something. It means exploitation. If we are finding the exploitation in the society, then we have to change that exploitation. We have to stop the exploitation. And for that, for those children, we have to provide the education. Okay. Then when we find the poverty in the society, we have to change that poverty into prosperity. We have to take the march. We have to be a part of that march, and we have to work to make a poor society to the prosper society. Okay. And lastly, Kailash Satyarthi says, let's march from ignorance to awakening. Let us march from darkness to light, and let's march from mortality to divinity. Let's march. In this way, this lesson ends here.